Turned to competition in 96. She's already been crowned the world all-around champion. Now she has her eyes on more gold. But a 17-year-old from the land of Nadia Komenich, Lavinia Agaki, has the same dreams. And just 6 months after being injured, East German Maxi Kanak is apparently back to the form that earned her 3 gold medals in the last World Championship. Challenging them all will be American Julianne McNamara. She's come to Budapest, Hungary, to meet the world's best gymnasts in the Women's World Individual Championships. As the Blue Danube, on its way to the Black Sea, it flows through the heart of Budapest, the 2,000-year-old capital of Hungary. 2 million people live and work here. It's a historic and beautiful city with its cobblestone streets, parks. And just a short way from downtown, a huge crowd is gathered in the new sports hall, the latest addition to Budapest's impressive sports complex. Hello again, everyone. I'm Chris Schenkel. We're in Budapest for more of the World Championships in Gymnastics, second only in importance to the Olympic Games. Today, we will see the finals of the women's individual apparatus competition. It's important for those that qualified because they can win individual gold medals. And secondly, it's the last opportunity for them to perform well to impress, further impress, the panel of international judges prior to the Los Angeles Olympic Games, which are only months away. With that in mind, delighted to be working again with Kathy Rigby. And Kathy, tell us about the ladies competing today.
Well, the competition for women should be very exciting. You have the best of the best on all four pieces of apparatus, and qualifying in all four events for the Soviet Union is 18-year-old Natalia Yurchenko. She could win at least 2 gold medals on the different apparatuses. And from the United States, Julianne McNamara has qualified in 2 of the events, the vaulting and the uneven parallel bars, so there's an outside chance that Julianne can win a medal, especially on the uneven bars. With that in mind, the main thing to look for here is lots of difficulty, no mistake, and good technique.
And first up the vault, the leader is Maxi Kanak of East Germany, the defending world champion. There's a 4-way tie for second. Natalia Yurchenko of the Soviet Union, Boriana Stoyanova, Bulgaria, and Romanian teammates Lavinia Agaki and Ekaterina Szabo. And they carry into this competition the marks from earlier team events. So today's marks will be added to those scores to determine the winner. There she is, the all-around champion, 18-year-old Natalia Yurchenko, Kathy.
And she has an impressive vault. She was the first ever to perform in world competition. It's a round off to the board. In fact, this was quite controversial at one time. Back handspring with full twist. Very nicely done.
And in this competition, both vaults count as we look at the young star of the Soviet Union, Natalia Yurchenko.
Both vaults have to be performed well. Both count, as you said, Chris.
And there is the mark, 9.9 for Yurchenko out of a possible perfect 10. Vault number 2 now.
And the second vault has to be different from the first. This is a full twisting Tsukahara. Timing is important off the board. Oops, a little low there. In fact, it's going to cost her 0.5 of a point.
What happened, Kathy? She's sitting there out of disgust, didn't like the vault, or what?
Well, it just looked like the timing on her vault was not good. It looks like her coach now is going to come over and see if there's any problem. But she was really just low on the beginning, it looked like. Timing on these vaults are so critical. If you don't get that punch off the horse, your landing can be real low. Looks like she was a little low coming in, and the shoulders way down.
Now for Yurchenko. No chance for a medal in the vault with only a 9.3 on her second.
Vaulting really pounds the body, and let's see if we can tell if anything is... You can see that her ankles are turned out slightly, which can cause the twisting in the knee.
And now Andrei Rodionenko is carrying this 100-pound gymnast off to the side here for undoubtedly observation, unable to get up and move on her own. That's a shame. And Boriana Stoyanova of Bulgaria in polka dots, ready with her first vault.
Powerful gymnast, Chris, in the floor exercise and on the vault. Her first vault will be a full twisting Tsukahara. Good stride. Very nice in the air. Perfect landing.
Yes,
excellent vault.
The 15-year-old discovery of the year, Stoyanova of Bulgaria. She is tiny. And now they have, as you see, placed Yurchenko on a stretcher. wisely, still unable to move on her own, and the medical attendants now will take her to a back room for further observation, no doubt, Kathy.
Whatever happens, does she know that she's not going to strain that knee anymore if that is the problem before the Olympics?
And there's Stoyanova's mark, 9.95, first vault. Here she is for her second.
The second vault is called a cuervo. It's a handspring. She makes a half twist in the air right into a backflip with 10.0. Excellent. Another good vault. A slight step there on the ending, but the vault is so difficult, I doubt the judges will take too much off of that.
This 15-year-old weighs 87. This 15-year-old weighs 87 pounds, her first world championship competition. Slow-mo now.
Because she just floats through the air. Good power. The run is so important on vaulting. You need to build up speed, punch off that horse, make your half twist. And in the air, you don't see those legs separate as much.
And there's her score on the second vault, 9.9. And Stoyanova now is the new leader in the vault competition. We'll be back.
Listen to these stars.
Hungary's kings and its conquerors. It had to be completely rebuilt after World War II. Other structures on the palace grounds still carry scars of that war, which left Budapest in ruins. Some are not being restored, serving as a permanent reminder of the horrors of war. Next up in the vault, Julianne McNamara of the United States. And as a youngster, she moved alone away from her family in California to Oregon.
It was really hard for me. I'm still close to my family, but I was really close with my family and with my sister, and it was a big decision for me to move away from home, but it was my choice. The area that I was living in, there weren't any gymnastics clubs around for me to train at, and I just had a feeling that if I tried, I'd have a chance at making the Olympic team, and that's what I wanted to do. So in order to do that and to achieve my goals, I had to go to a training center where I could get the coaching and work with other girls at the same level. The time I spent in Oregon worked out really well, and I learned a lot. But I just reached the point where I wasn't really improving and I wasn't reaching my potential, and it was time to move on.
So she moved back to Southern California for further training, still 500 miles from home, but now her mother's joined her.
The reason why I came down to live with Julianne is because SCATS has a parent-run organization, and when Julianne was first went to SCATS, that was the idea that the parents had to participate, and Julianne was accepted under those rules, and therefore I had to come down at least once, a minimum of once a month, and sometimes three times a month, which meant that I was driving 1,000 to 3,000 miles a month to participate in the activities of fundraising. Another reason also that we decided for me to come down here is Julianne has lived away from home for 4 years. And we're just about 500 miles away, and it was constant back and forth, and this way there was more stability.
For Julianne
and for us.
Even though medalist in previous world championship competition, like any gymnast, she has to live with occasional adversity.
I think sometimes when I've had adversity, I haven't done as well as I've wanted to. It's even made me, I've wanted more and made the triumphs I've had even more meaningful to me. I went through a hard stage once I got into high school, I think, where I was kind of debating whether it was all worth it and everything, and I felt kind of like I was missing out on some things, but I think everybody sort of goes through that. And what it all came down to is I really do think it is all worth it. I've benefited a lot through my gymnastics, and I figure that when I get into college or when I get out of gymnastics, I'll have time to do all the kinds of things that maybe I've missed out on, maybe some of the social things. But I've traveled all over the world, and I've met a lot of neat people, and I've experienced a lot of things that I never would have been able to if it wasn't for my gymnastics.
She's experienced adversity, and she's learned from it. True qualities which make Julianne a world-class gymnast. Tied for sixth coming in. Kathy sustaining an illness here in Hungary and not up to par.
This is a good event for Julianne. Although she's not throwing the most difficult vault, she's throwing a 9.9 vault that's in the code of points. It's a layout Sukahara, but they have to do two vaults, both of them different, and they both count. Position in the air, a little step backwards, her legs separated just slightly off the board.
Julianne McNamara.
You know, it's difficult for these gymnasts to prepare two different vaults and be equally skilled on both. And on this particular vault, at this angle, Julianne is a little bit flat on the landing.
A 9.70 for Julianne McNamara.
Chris, that's a bit of a disappointing score, but you're starting from a 9.9, and the judges take off from there instead of a 10. Getting ready for a second vault now. Full twisting Sukahara. Both vaults are different, remember. This is worth a 10 in the code of points. She's going over the vault in her head many times. Good ending. A little bit low with the shoulders.
Better than the first?
Better than the first. More difficult than the first, especially.
And the face being the mirror of how you feel, you can see that she's not feeling well. So it's a 9.8 on her second vault.
Well, she's out of it for the vault, but she has a solid chance on the uneven bars. And then being comforted by teammate Kathy Johnson, who is an alternate in the competition.
You're looking at the leader coming in from East Germany, Maxi Gnock.
This has been a bit of a disappointing competition for her, but I'm sure she's going to try to make up here in the individual apparatus. Good vault, full twisting Sukahara.
This 19-year-old has had just tremendous success in the World Championships, Maxi Gnock.
She has had great success. In the last World Championship, not only was she first on this event, but she also took the gold on the uneven bars and balance beam. Take another look at that full twisting Sukahara. Good power off the horse. A little separation in the legs, however.
So for the young lady from East Berlin, it's a 9.9.
Since for her second vault, she's chosen a layout Sukahara that's only worth a 9.9 in quota points, and she needs a 9.95 to stay in the lead. She's going to have to forfeit her lead.
But why would she choose a vault that's not worth a 10?
Well, either she's not prepared to perform another difficult 10-point vault, or the risk of performing one isn't worth the added 10.
For Maxi Gnock of East Germany, it's a 9.8. When we return, we'll see two solid contenders for the championship. Agaki of Romania, with a 9.9 in her first vault, needs a 10 right here to take the lead.
And that is not out of her range. She has been so polished in this competition. All the Romanians have, mentally prepared. Cartwheel front with a half twist, good landing, a little step there, but not bad. Difficult vault, good distance from the horse.
A 17-year-old from Romania, part of the new wave of competitors from that country. And there's a 9.9, the same as her first vault. Lavinia Agaki, and there's one last competitor that has a chance to win, and that's her teammate, Ekaterina Szabo.
Another extremely confident gymnast in this competition. She's doing a Cuervo. Strong runner. This is an important part of the vault, getting that speed. Ricochet off. Good vault. Both have had a little hop on the end, but that's only about a tenth of a point.
Look at that concentration of the 16-year-old Ekaterina Szabo.
And obviously concentration is the most important thing in gymnastics. Now, at the end of her vault, you'll see a separation in her legs. It's very controversial with the judges. Some like it and some don't, and some will take off for it.
Szabo getting a 9.9.
Now Ekaterina's getting ready for a second vault. She chose a vault worth a 10 in the code of points, unlike Maxi Gnock, who chose a vault only worth 9.9. She can receive a gold medal here, but that step is going to make it very difficult for her.
A former European junior champion awaiting the score on that second vault. Her fans cheering here in the sports hall. A 9.9, a tenth of a point short. The final results, Stoyanova, Bulgaria, the winner, Szabo and Agaki tied for second, Gnock fourth, Julianne McNamara tied for sixth. So for 15-year-old Stoyanova, she wins the first World Championship gold medal ever for a Bulgarian gymnast. Will she be the new favorite for the games in Los Angeles?
We have a report on the condition of Natalia Yurchenko, who sustained an injury following a fall on her second vault today. The report is that it's either a severe bruise or a dislocation of her right knee, and at the moment, a Soviet physician, Kathy, is treating her. What if she can't compete?
Well, in the case of an injury, the top alternate will move in, and on the floor exercise, America's Kathy Johnson will move in if your Yurchenko can't compete.
So we'll be back here on ABC's Wide World of Sports for that story as they move to the uneven bars.
St. Basil's Cathedral in Red Square in the heart of Moscow. If there's a more familiar site in the Soviet Union, I can't imagine where it is. School children come from all over the country to have their pictures taken in front of Lenin's tomb. This is the Izmailovo Sports Palace, site of today's World Weightlifting Championships. Hello, everybody. I'm Bob Yadier, working with me.
Symbolically east towards the Soviet Union is this monument to the Soviet soldiers who ended the German occupation of the city at the end of World War II. Built in 1947, the statue joins a massive citadel built a century earlier on Gellert Hill, once covered by the richest vineyards in the area, as we return to the sports hall for more competition in the World Gymnastics Championships.
Here are the standings coming into the uneven bars competition. A two-way tie for first, Maxi Ganok of East Germany, Natalia Yurchenko of the Soviet Union, who sustained a knee injury. We don't know to what extent, but nevertheless, she is in the stands, definitely out of the competition, and in the uneven bars, she'll be replaced by the first alternate. But looking down the way in competition, in the floor exercise, the alternate, Kathy Johnson of the United States. So she'll be competing in the floor exercise instead of Natalia Yurchenko. We'll first see Julianne McNamara of the United States, who comes in tied for fifth. Now, the American team has been concerned and upset with the judging here in Budapest, especially as it relates to Julianne's mark on the uneven bars in the all-around competition. They even considered pulling her out of this event. For more on that, here's Kathy.
With me is Mike Jackie, Executive Director of the United States Gymnastic Federation. And Mike, I know in the competition, in the all-around competition, you had a lot of trouble with Julianne's bar routine score.
Yes, we did, Kathy. Of course, she did an excellent exercise, and there's a panel of three arbitrary judges. All of the judges gave her a 10-0. The head judge gave her a 10-0. The New Zealand judge gave her a 10-0. Mm-hmm. But then the other three scores from East Germany, Romania, and Bulgaria were all 9-9s. Mm-hmm. And, of course, that meant a 9-9. We protested the score, and the protest was rejected because they said it wasn't written in a polite manner. The point of the thing is we asked them to evaluate the score against other 10-0 exercises. And it was very unfortunate. It was probably the best exercise of the day. And, you know, we continue to have this battle and this problem. We considered pulling Julianne from the competition, but, of course, we want to stay out of that. And we don't want to use that type of politics. We want Julianne to have the opportunity to perform. We have a neutral panel in the finals today. But it's very unfortunate that these type of situations continue to happen and it has been very prevalent in this competition, even to the point in one of the Romanian athletes who stepped out of bounds, which is a mandatory 1/10 deduction, the flag went up, and she still received a perfect 10.0. And it's an atrocity that has to be changed, and I really don't know what we're going to be able to do about it.
So here she is, 18-year-old Julianne McNamara of the United States.
And I'm sure she feels a great deal of pressure. She starts with a mixed grip, shoots right to a handstand. Gonna try for that perfection. Giant swing. Right into a reverse hex, beautifully done. So far moving well. Drop to the low bar. Great form, tight legs. Mixed grip again, right into a handstand. Try to go right to the handstand every time, right into a front somi. Oh, 5/10 of a point right there. A lot of pressure, big disappointment. Shooting well now, right through to the top bar. Big disappointment for Julianne. Stalters.
Nevertheless, lots of potential for the Los Angeles Olympic Games. Kathy, for Julianne, more adversity.
Well, it's hard enough to concentrate on peaking for a world-class man, but to add on top of that the worry of how you're going to be scored by the judges, whether or not your federation will let you compete, and to be ill at the same time, that's incredibly hard to do. Hopefully in the future there can be a way to protest injustices without involving the gymnasts and adding further pressure to an already highly pressured situation.
Lavinia Agaki of Romania.
Powerful gymnast on all four events. This is a specialty of hers. She mounts with a straddle over the low bar, and she moves right into what's called a delchev.
Tied for third.
She goes. Toe on, toe off. Mixed grip right into a delcho, drop to the low bar. Moving quite well so far, right into stalters. Each stalter should be done right to a handstand. Double leg shoot through. There's another giant getting prepared for her dismount now. Double flyaway. No slips on that landing. Good exercise.
During the team competition, she got a 10 on the uneven bars. Lavinia Agaki of Romania.
The Romanians are, as we've said in the past, so strong on a real comeback here. Hugged by her teammate, Ekaterina Szabo.
And her performance earns her a 9.9. This is Maxi Gounod, who severely dislocated her left elbow at the European Championships. In some said she had only a 10% chance of ever competing again. So we asked her how long after her operation in May was she able to start training again.
She was operated after the injury in Berlin, and the operation was successful, so she could train again very soon. She started almost immediately with training on her legs, a kind of alternative training, and in August she started complete training again.
This is Maxi Gounod of East Germany. Has a chance to win. Yurchenko is out because of an injury.
Well, she's won almost every major event on this apparatus anyway. And she moves so well. She's grown a great deal. That's a delchev. Perfect position on every move so far. One difficulty after another. Right to the handstand. Nice form and technique. Vault over the high bar, drop to the low bar. Lots of confidence in this routine. Good form. She's moving real well, way above the bar. I think you're going to see a 10 on this.
Recovering from injuries throughout the last few years and still in there, one of the truly best in the world.
One of the first smiles of the day from Maxi.
Kathy, let's take a look at that great performance in slow motion.
It certainly was a great routine, and you certainly can't see very many breaks, if any at all. In slow motion, you can see a slight angle problem there, but when she's moving as quickly as she is during the competition, it's difficult for the judges to see any problems.
And Kathy, as you predicted, there it is, a perfect 10. Maxi Gounod, 10 is her third perfect mark here in Budapest. She is the leader. Overall, here in Hungary, it's the 16th 10 received by a woman.
And she is a defending world champion on this event.
Most of his life in Vienna. But in 1800, he lived in this house in Budapest. Currently, the house is being restored to be used as apartment housing. And now we return to our coverage of the World Gymnastics Championships. This is Ekaterina Szabo, who entered this event tied for third and needs a 9.95 to overtake her teammate Agaki for second.
As we've seen throughout the competitions, the Romanians are on a comeback since Nadia Comăneci. Right now, she's going to do a straddle with a full twist, first invented by Ludmila Tarasheva, who is now a judge. Moving quite well so far. Giant swings, toe on, toe off. Beautifully executed so far. Double flyaway. Great routine.
Exciting. Crowd loving it here in Budapest, Hungary.
It'll be one to watch for in Los Angeles at the Olympics on this event.
Maxi Gounod has already clinched the gold in this event with her perfect 10. And there with the 9.9, a tie for second, Agaki and Szabo. Julianne McNamara finished seventh. Kathy, you mentioned Ludmila Tarasheva. Well, she's here as a superior judge, and it seems like only yesterday she was competing. There she is. She didn't win the most medals or bring any daredevil acrobatics to her sport. But Ludmila Tarasheva, like Peggy Fleming on ice or Nureyev in concert, had the kind of grace that only very rare performers have. At the 1972 Olympics in Munich, while her teammate Olga Korbut was changing gymnastics with seemingly impossible flips and bends, Tarasheva was at her best, winning the all-around where Olga only managed seventh place. From 1968 until she retired in 1976, she won 9 Olympic medals and 11 more in world championships, and always with that special sense of ballet that captivated everyone who watched her perform.
Her
grace and balletic sense was never more evident than here on the floor exercise.
When we return to Budapest, we'll see the world's best competing in the floor exercise event, including America's Kathy Johnson, who now gets a chance to compete because of an injury to Natalia Yurchenko. Hungary is right here, from the top of the Fisherman's Bastion on the Buda side of the river. Named after the fish market it was built next to, the fort looks across the Danube and the city's eight bridges to the Pest side. 2.5 miles away from Fisherman's Bastion, the Budapest Sports Hall, and more of the world's gymnastics championships. We move now to the floor exercise. The leader is Ekaterina Szabo of Romania with a three-way tie for second between Lavinia Agaki of Romania, Boriana Stoyanova of Bulgaria, and Olga Mastepanova of the Soviet Union. Should be quite a battle. Up first, Lavinia Agaki of Romania, 17 years old and good.
She's a great gymnast, and she's starting with a full-in double back, a very difficult move. If she nails this particular move, she's on her way home. The most difficult move in the competition. Many of the gymnasts have it. She nailed it. Very nice. The Romanians have made a great improvement on their dance on the floor exercise. Still the style of Nadia Comăneci, but the lines are better. There's more ballet. And their flexibility is better. Now watch this move. It's a 2.5 twist step out. Kind of a blind move. You can't see where you're landing. Does it very well. Have to show flexibility, as you can see there.
Change the tempo beautifully in the music.
That's one of the requirements, Chris.
Instead of live piano, it is now recorded music, and the only event in gymnastics where they perform to music.
This is the whole routine of fuller sound, and the gymnasts have a little more to choose from. Very nice exercise.
Lavinia Agaki of Romania.
It's difficult when the gymnasts are tumbling so fast to see what they're doing. This is her full-in double back. And you'll see that she goes 2 times around and makes a full twist on the first back flip. Very nicely done.
And do you agree with that score? 9.9.
I think it's absolutely on, right on.
And here's one of the gold medalists winning it today, Stoyanova, winning it on the vault. Young, 15, sort of a discovery of the year.
She's excellent on this apparatus as well, on the floor exercise. She starts with a full-in pike. She has 4 tumbling runs rather than just 3. She starts with a full-in in the pike position. 2 back flips and a full twist. Instead of all tucked up, she pikes. Boy, does she nail it. As you can tell, her tumbling is the strongest part of the exercise. Cover all 4 sides of the floor exercise mat. Here's your second tumbling run. Whip over right into a double back. Talk about power.
Real acrobat.
You can see how those ankles are taped. It takes a lot of pounding. Just a double twist right in the middle of the routine.
Because that mat is not as soft as it looks.
Well, it actually is pretty springy, but when you're doing full-in double backs and double twists, your ankles just take a lot of abuse. And here's her 4th tumbling run. Great endurance. Double back. She doesn't look like she's tired at all.
Yeah.
Can't do much better than that.
In her first world championship competition, Boriana Stoyanova of Bulgaria. Gold in the vault. Let's see what her score will be here.
Chris, we keep talking about leg strength and power. This tumbling run really shows that off. does a back hamstring into a whip over and has enough power to go right into a double back and execute it well. A little low on the shoulders, but not bad at all.
And the 15-year-old gets a 9.95, thus moving her ahead of Agaki by 0.05 of a point. Coming up next, Olga Mustapanova of the Soviet Union. A little earlier, she won on the beam. Let's take a look at it.
She has great flexibility on this apparatus. She moves well. She moved a little costly throughout the routine, but there were no major breaks, and the difficulty was there. And here is one of her difficult moves. Back handspring right into a back layout. Solid as a rock there. You know, Chris, we're seeing a lot of these women setting themselves up for the Olympics and showing the judges and the world of gymnastics what they can do. Aerial walk over there. Every move was very secure.
With one gold, can she get another? Olga Mustapanova.
Chris, she has everything. Flexibility, strength, grace, difficulty. Every move she makes is perfect. Or near perfection. Here's her full in. Full twisting, double back. Almost stepped out, but she didn't. Pretty tight there in the corner.
She needs a 9.95 to tie for the lead.
Beautiful topo on her second tumbling run. Full twisting, handspring, unusual front tumbling, got into a double twist. Done so effortlessly.
Another Olga from the Soviet Union.
Not quite the same personality, but boy, does she have the flexibility and grace. It sure is a throwback to the old times where ballet was so important. And her last tumbling run is a double back, taking a little rest here in the corner. Breath. Lots of endurance needed here. Good landing. Now she can rest.
Olga Mustapanova, the Soviet Union. 15 years old, trying for her second gold medal here in the individual apparatus final of the World Championships.
Thing about Olga is that not only does she have great flexibility, but she also has the strength to go along with it, which doesn't always happen. That's a hamstring front with a full twist right into another double twist. Beautifully done.
And the young lady with the ponytail, a perfect 10, Olga Mustapanova. Name to certainly look for at the Los Angeles Olympic Games. Two more yet to perform, including the leader, Szabo, along with Kathy Johnson of the United States. And now we go to the leader of this event, the floor exercise, 16-year-old Ekaterina Szabo of Romania. She needs a 9.95, Kathy, to win.
She's a bundle of energy, and this is her best event. She starts with a full in. She tumbles with ease. Already has the audience on her side. She's going to have a lot of fun here. There's a full in double back. Excellent. Right on. Round off split jump. Nice combination. Slight bobble there on that full turn. One and a half twist, round off the flop. Double twist, front flip. Tumbling run. Another full in. Woo! She's made that around. She'll be the champ.
All this in Hungary, wisely using gypsy music, Sardis here and there, and what a performance, and this Hungarian crowd, predominantly Hungarian, is enjoying it. She needs a 9.95 to win her third medal today. Two silvers prior to this. Tati Szabo, and it's a 10. She is the floor exercise champion.
What intestinal fortitude. The confidence throughout the meet is shown, even through this long, grueling competition. So well eschewed. Right into a punch front there. 1.5 to a punch front.
And with her 10, Szabo of Romania is the winner. Mastapanova is second from Soviet Union, and Stoyanova of Bulgaria third. Kathy Johnson of the United States. What a tough act to follow. Not only that, but coming in late because of an injury to Yurchenko.
You know, Chris, Kathy can't win a medal on this competition. The three places are already taken, but she can enjoy it. She can enjoy being out there, having the opportunity to be in a world championships and be in the finals. I think she loves this opportunity. She's a performer.
Using that Russian music, dark eyes.
Triple twist. She stepped out there. Have a lot of energy. She's been able to rest all day. The other side is mentally she's had very little time to get ready for this competition. She didn't find out about being on this event, so Yurchenko scratched the meet due to injury and vault. You can see there she had a slight bobble, stepping a little bit to the right. Are showing right here. Beautiful ballet line.
24 years old, oldest of the top 15 qualifiers, and you know, this is her third world championship competition.
Experience shows. And I believe this to be the best competition for Kathy. Double back. Whoops, problem there. About 3/10 of a point.
Still a very tough situation coming in from an alternate position to replace Natalia Yurchenko, the all-around world champion. Yurchenko having injured a knee, but nevertheless, Kathy did get to perform before this full house.
Even though Kathy had some problems on this event, she has to be proud of her overall performance in the competition. Let's take another look at that last tumbling run when she did have the big mistake. Right in the double pipe, she just didn't get quite enough rotation.
These are long moments for the competitor, Kathy Johnson, and her coach on the left, Don Peters, the United States Olympic women's coach. Here's the mark now, a 9.40, a bitter disappointment for Kathy. There are four new world champions, the vault won by Stoyanova of Bulgaria, Maxi Ganok successfully defending on the unevens of East Germany.
With the Olympics, we had an unfortunate situation in that many of our top gymnasts were ill or injured, and I'm talking about Mary Lou Retton, Diane Durham, and Tracy Talavera.